So click on loads and surface loads here. Okay, surface loads, pounds per square foot. So I want to do our 8-inch slab. So I'm just going to say, I'm going to try to type 8-inch slab. And how much does an 8-inch slab weigh? Concrete weighs 150 pounds a cubic foot. 8/12 of that, 2/3 of 150 is. Okay. Plus the miscellaneous, probably gonna have ceiling, some flooring. Dr. Hazelton wants, you know, fancy ceramic tile, right?
Anything that's nice.
Anything that's nice. We'll give him some nice 10 pound a square foot ceramic tile. Maybe another 10 pounds for ceiling and miscellaneous, so call it 120 pounds square foot. PSF. For concrete, you don't have to put any construction dead load in there. If you're doing composite steel, you would. Live load. What kind of live load does Dr. Hazelton like? What's a live load for an office building? Anybody know? Code wise, I'll tell you it's 50 pounds a square foot. If usually most owners will want a net 100 pounds a square foot because they want to be able to, that becomes a leasing issue. So we can put in, what I do is I'll usually put in 85 for the live load and 15 partition loads are 15 pounds a square foot. That accounts for walls that can be moved. And the 85 plus 15 will get us up to 100 pound net live load. So I've given Dr. Hazelton 100 pounds he wants in case he wants to lease the space out to somebody. The partition load is non-reducible in the code. You can't take it down because they're figuring these, it's really for movable partitions and their weights aren't going to change over a large area. So the code doesn't let you reduce them. That's why they're input separately. And then we can put reducible for the other loads.
Do they like the 100 so that they can make it where corridor and office can be moved around? Is that the idea?
Yeah. Well, mostly they like it because companies like larger capacities.
Keep the numbers.
All right. The other thing, since we didn't put in, have the program to figure out the masses of our floor system, we have to put in how much seismic mass we want here. So usually it's the same as the dead load, 120. And if we were doing composite steel, we'd put in a construction load here. So let's add that. And hit OK. So we've got a proper table with the load. So I'm going to put this load over the whole floor. So layout, loads, surface loads. Click on the load in our property table. There's only one. And we can stick it over the whole floor. And it's going to turn this thing into yellow here. So that yellow shows you that that load is over the whole floor. If you wanted a, say Dr. Hazelton, he wants a, you know, hot tub in his office. So we go back to the property tables, loads, surface, and we'll call it the hot tub. And we'll say, still have 120 pounds of dead load, but this time we're going to put an unreducible hot tub load of 200 pounds. Is that big enough? How big is 62 pounds, 3 feet of water. That's about close, isn't it? Does he want more? He want a deeper one? Okay, we'll have to be satisfied with 200 pounds. And again, keep the mass weight in there. So we'll add that. And let's say his hot tub wants to be in one of these bays, so we'll go back. We can get loads here. Hot tub. And we'll add it. And then we have to click on some points to make a rectangle. And you can have this hot tub anywhere in that. And so the point is, when you put in a new load, it overwrites what was there before. So this is now the only thing that's in this bay is the hot tub load. So that's why we had to keep the weight of the floor plus the new live load on it. Another type of load is, we're going to have some perimeter walls on our building, right? Like that. Those have some weight to them. So we want to put what's called a line load out on the perimeter. That's kind of a load per foot, right, instead of an area, so we can define line loads. And we'll call it exterior wall. And how much does a wall weigh? I don't know, 20 pounds a square foot, that's it. Does he have plaster? You know, you have to figure out what's on the outside. How much does windows weigh? Windows are usually 8 to 10 pounds a square foot. Plaster weighs 10 pounds a square foot. Jibboard weighs about 3. Some studs weighs a couple. So it's going to be 15 to 20 pounds. So if it's 20 pounds and quarter floor heights, 15 feet. 20 pounds a square foot times 15 feet of drip height. It's about, 300 pounds a linear foot. So let's go. Now notice this is in kips per foot, so we need to put it in as 0.3. And again, we want the program to mass out our building seismically, so we need to put in 0.3 down there. There is no live load on a wall, right? So we don't need to add a live load at all. So we can add that and hit OK. And now we can define, you notice this button here is highlighted now, so we can lay out the line loads, or we can go back to layout, loads, line loads, click on our exterior wall, and the nice thing, we can select, if there's an exterior wall around the whole perimeter, we can just select whole perimeter, or we can put it on individually if we want. So if I wanted to add, I could add it on a beam. So if I click that and then just put the button over there, it'll stick it on that beam. I can right click and go hit add, and then I can put the plus sign over a point and drag it down to another point. And click again and we'll add. So you gotta be careful. Click and go add on beam. Or I could have just clicked the whole perimeter and wouldn't have to do all of that. Alright, and we could do the same thing. We have point loads available to us if we wanted to create a property table with loads and point loads. We could create a downward load if, I don't know, what would you hang in a building that has a lot of point load on it? K mechanical unit or something maybe. So you could put a 10 kip point load. Let's say a mechanical unit here. And these are in kips, so 10 kips of point load. And again, mass it out, so get the 10 kips there. Add it. Now we have a mechanical unit. And then we can go back to layout, loads, point loads. Select our point load. We can put it on grid or on a beam. So maybe I just want to stick it over, stick it on a beam, add on beam. And the distance from the left end, 10 feet maybe. And then hit add. Now I got to click on a beam. Click on one end or the other end, whichever end it's 10 feet from. And then it puts a yellow dot in. So there's a 10 kip mechanical unit sitting on a beam. Alright, I'm going to save this away. And we've got a floor. We haven't assigned any story data yet. In other words, how tall is this floor off the ground or from the next floor? So let's go, we've done our layout, let's go over to story now. Click there. We've got a floor type, typical floor. We could have had a, we're gonna do another floor in steel in a second. So we have something there. And we have to label this, so we'll call this the second floor. And how high from the ground to the second floor?
14 feet.
And splice level, if you're doing steel over here, can we splice the column at the second level? And normally for concrete, it doesn't matter, but for steel, it does. Normally, you wouldn't splice it at the second floor. You'd go up about 40 feet or something before you try to splice it. Steel column. So we'll hit add. So now we've got a story height. So now we've got this view button, 3D view. We can click on it. And it's going to render our building in 3D there. And then it, you can drag it, you can hit control and rotate it, turn it upside down, and spin it around, do whatever you want. Like that. This button over here turns off the deck so we can get rid of the deck and see all the beams. Nice 3D view. It's good to look at. Kind of see your model, see if it looks like what you think it should look like. And then we'll get out of this view and back to our plan. We can also do an elevation view, this button here. You have to click on some lateral frame to view, and then we can zoom in here. There's a zoom button, a square fence button. We'll zoom this out. And we can take a look at that frame and elevation. So you can see it's got the column size, it's got the beam size up above. And then if we want to go back to the plan, it's this plan we've got up here. Alright, so I think we've modeled one story. We've got the floor heights. So now we can do a data check. That's this data check button over here. And we've got a gravity only, I kind of start there, hit okay. And it says no errors or warnings found. Woohoo, right? Or if you had something screwed up, it would hopefully tell you. You can look at our integrated or frame only, check the lateral system. And no errors or warnings, so looking pretty good. All right, should we model a steel floor? Are you steel guys?
Please.
Steel guys in here, women? At least one, two, three. Oh, okay. All right, so we need to do a new floor layout, right? We don't want to use this floor layout. We want to do a steel floor, so let's go back up to layout and type. Now we're going to go, steel floor, and we'll add it. Now we have a new layout type, and we're going to select it now. And now there's nothing there, right? So we'd like to copy up, we want to keep the same grids, probably. You don't want to keep the same columns, the same beams, same floor, so just the grids. So go back to layout, type, and hit copy this time. And we're going to copy to this level from the typical floor. We just want the grid lines. We could copy all of it if we wanted to. If the next floor up was concrete, we're just going to make a few changes. But we'll at least get the grid lines, hit OK. And there's the grids.
Where was the copy link?
It's on the layout type.
Okay.
Copy is right here. Yeah.
Wait, how did you create a new floor again?
How did I add it?
Yeah.
I went to layout, select, and then I just typed in something right there.
Oh, okay.
And then I hit add.
Yeah.
And I put it in there. Notice it's not bold yet. The reason it's not bold is because we haven't defined it in our story name. But it's a floor type we can work on. All right. So, first thing, columns, right? And I have columns, that's the place to start. So, layout. So, now we want to do steel, right? So we're going to change our material from other to steel. And we want to lay out columns, so we can hit this icon to turn on all the column buttons. And we want to lay out some gravity columns. So a standard column, gravity column, 50 grade steel, that's the standard. I section, you want to do I sections? Okay. And which way do you want to orient them? We're going to run, let's see, this is 30 foot, 25. We're going to run the girders up and down the short direction. So I would say the orientation of the column ought to be in the girder direction that has the larger loads. Select that orientation, hit fence, and we'll do all the interior columns or that, and you can see it puts them in blue again. They're gravity columns, they're, you can see the orientation, and they're wide flange columns. Put in some lateral columns for a, we're going to go steel long frame. That's perfect. All right. So again, layout, columns, add-on grid. This time we want to make them lateral columns, and we'll orient the ones on 111 up and down the sheet. Fence them in. Same thing over here. Now, whenever you put in lateral elements, you have to model in a size. Okay, because when you get to the lateral part of the program, it's going to figure out the stiffness, but it has to know a size. So on these, we're going to have to assign a size. So we'll go over here to the size button, or we can go to layout, columns, assign size, either way. And W, I don't know. Lateral frame size, larger 14, or sometimes they make larger, like W27s by 94, or sometimes very efficient. So you have to come up with something. And this is where you could use those approximate methods we used in 313, remember that portal method? You could come up with some moments and pick a size, design a column preliminarily, and put it in the program here, and hopefully you're close. So that was the whole purpose of that exercise. Let's go at 27 by 94. How's that? The other thing is you go some to heavy 14 a lot of times. So we'll fence those sizes in. And we need to do same thing in the other direction, so we'll assign sizes, lateral. This time we'll turn them the other way. And we have 5 bays of lateral frame columns. Is that right?
Yeah.
We have 6. Go back to the next floor because we can't remember. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So from bid 4 to 9. All right. And we'll right click, we'll get back to the same menu. Put them in down here. And I need a couple gravity columns over here that I've forgotten. So we'll go back to gravity. And we'll stick them in the same orientation as all the rest of them. Got all our columns to resize these up here. I don't think we did. Make them the same size. All right, beams. So we go to our beam module. We can click here. Add on grid if we want. Gravity beams. This floor we're going to be composite, right? That's how we do metal deck concrete fill for a floor, so we want to go composite, 50 psi, that's it. And go like that. Put some in here in the middle. There. A couple up here. Gravity beam. And over here. You're pretty fast at this, right? Lateral beam, so I can right click again, go to lateral. Generally, don't design those composite, you go non composite, so fence. And we'll stick them in between our lateral columns. Okay, I stuck some over here, so I have to delete them, this X button. I'm gonna delete my gravity ones, and then I'll come back to assigning beams, lateral ones. Now we need to assign sizes to our lateral elements, and I guess 24 by 76. That's a kind of a good starting point for steel. And again, fence them in, and it's okay, which way is our metal deck gonna span? Generally on steel framing, you want the girders to go the short direction. The typical framing joists will go in the long direction. So we have 30 feet here and 25 feet here, right? So we'll make these are girders, these will be our beams, and we'll span the deck this way. Let's see, so 50 feet, so if we put them in at 10 foot on center, that's a nice number. 15 stretching and 3 inch deck, quite a bit. So you want to be somewhere between 10 and 15 feet on center. 12 and a half is a nice number. So let's see, no, this is 25 feet, so we can go 12 and a half and put it right in the middle. So beams, we can do an array where we put in 2 bays, gravity beams, composite, and hit add, and then we can go, this will work, let's see what happens. So I clicked on 2 points, and then it says, do you want the beam to the left of this beam or the right? So if I click left, it'll put it there. Let's see. If I go highlight all the way down, what happens? So it'll go ahead and fill them all in that way. So I can start up here, click down, hold it, click on this one, click on the side I want it. Every single day. Okay, so let's click there, drag down, click there, click to the right, click there, drag down, click again, click to the right. Up here, I don't have a girder there, do I? So I'm going to delete that beam, hit the X, symbol, get rid of that guy. Go back to this layout. Add on grid, gravity, fence, get that girder in. Okay, now I looks like I have them all in there. 12 and a half feet on center. It's a nice spacing for the concrete. That'll it. All right, we got the beams, we got the columns. Now we need what? What did we do before? Slab edge? Yeah. So let's go back up to our layout slab, or we can go layout here, slab edge. We can keep the 12 inches, and I can click on the whole perimeter button. And as long as I have beams around the whole perimeter, it will put it in for us. All right, now we need a composite metal deck, don't we? So we're gonna go to layout, slab, deck assigned. Oh, we gotta go to property table. So the nice thing, there's a button to get us back to the property table. Here we're at a composite floor system. So we need to select the type of deck, this left column. ASC3W. My company always specifies Verco 3W. W3 means it's a 3-inch deck. W means it's for concrete. Stud diameter 3/4, that's pretty standard. You don't do short construction, so don't mess with those. We'll call this the steel floor deck. And if we're gonna do the 2-hour slab, we need 4.5 inches of concrete over the deck. So we want 4.5 inches there. The stud length, 6 inches will work. You have to be an inch above the top of the flute. You have to be less than a half inch, or more than a half inch or more from the top of the slab. So somewhere in between there. So a 6-inch stud is a nice value. This is lightweight concrete. You want to do lightweight or you want to do regular weight? So I've got a 4.5 inches. That's a regular weight concrete for a 2-hour floor. So we're going to go back to 150 pounds here. 3 KSI concrete is good. The stud value, that's good. Self-weight of the metal deck, 3 pounds, that's good. So I'm kind of liking what we've got. Hit OK. And now we come back to the same thing. Which way is the deck running now? Up and down or left and right? Short direction or long direction?
Up and down.
Up and down, short direction. We only span 10 to 15 feet. So let's click the up and down. It's a one-way slab. It's composite. And we're going to add it. Where do we add it?
Did you forget to add it?
I forgot to add it before. I did forget to add it. All right, redo it. One and a half, stud length is 6, 150, and go Verco, and all the rest is good. All right, so there it is. So we'll select it, and we'll run it up and down, and we'll put it over the whole floor. And again, you can see those, you can make those lines out. These purple lines run vertical, showing you which way the deck's going. All right, deck, we need loads, right? So let's go to our load button. That's this button, or you can go back to layout and loads. All right, well, we don't want a concrete load. We don't want that. So we're going to go back to our property table and loads and define a new load for the floor. Floor. And the typical load for a steel floor is going to be on a neighborhood of 80 pounds a square foot. Which you look up in the Verco table, so I'll just stick that in. Live load, we said 85, Dr. Hastenson wants, plus the partition load of 15. And again, we got to put in a mass dead load of this deck, again at 80 pounds. And here we have to put in a construction dead load. That's the weight of the wet concrete, the metal deck, any miscellaneous that's on there. Because we have to size the beam and make sure that it will hold up the wet concrete before it will harden. So this will usually be, I don't know, 70 pounds. It's a little less than the total dead load. And we need a construction live load for the workers on the deck while they're pouring the concrete. At least 20 pounds, I like to use 25. Kind of like a little more than a typical roof. So that's just my personal preference, but you don't want to be any less than 20. All right, we'll add that in. So that's in our property table. Now we can go back to our loads, surface loads, steel floor, and we'll add this to the whole floor. And there it is. Now we've got a floor load on. All right, we've got this typical steel level set up. So we need to put it in our story data now. So now our second elevated level, we had 14 feet before. You want to go 14 again? I know, that's a pretty good number. The floor type now is a steel floor. We have to call it something, so this is the second, third floor. Splice level, I'd say no, it's not splice at this level. And we'll add it in here, and now we've got the third floor made out of steel. We wanted to have another level of steel framing exactly the same. We just go to the fourth floor here. It's a steel floor, 14 feet. And we hit add again. And now we have two steel floors in our model. Hit okay. So now we can look at the 3D picture. And I'll get rid of the deck by clicking this button. And now you can kind of see. If you hit control and hold down the cursor button, you can rotate this quickly and you can see the steel framing. Now if you're doing a steel building and you want to put a roof on it, you're not going to put, probably not going to put concrete on the roof, so you need another framing plan for the roof that has different loads, because now we don't have concrete. So you copy up the steel framing, but this time you change the load on the steel beams. All right, we got 5 minutes. Let's design the whole thing here. At least from a gravity standpoint. Let's do data check. Oh, lucky, no errors. All right, so let's save this away. We'll get out of the modeler. And we'll go to this beam design button down here. We'll hit perform design all. Hit the magic button. It frames the building out. Then starts designing every beam, and now it's done. How bad, huh? How long would it take you by hand to do all these beams? So here's our floor. Let's take a look. We can turn on the beam sizes somewhere. Where is that button? Right here? No, that's a sign. View update. Sign all right here, this button. Show designs. So I'm going to zoom in here somewhere. Just have one part of one page. And it selected 16 by 31s with 16 studs on it, 1-inch camber. Girders for 21 by 44 with 16 studs, no camber. All right. Let's see, we got time to design the columns, don't we? Let's get out of here. Go to the column module, that's the next button down. It doesn't design your concrete beam, sorry guys. And let's see. trial group defaults. Let's see what trial groups we're going to get here. So it's going to check for, if we modeled an I section, which we did, it's going to check for W14s, W12s, and W10s. So that looks reasonable. So we'll hit this design all button right here. And it's designing all the columns, and we're done. Turn off the decking. And we're going to turn off the gravity beams so we can just see the steel columns. And it gives you a color-coded thing here of the sizes as far as stress. So yellow is what, 0.9 to 0.95? That's the supply and demand ratio, if you will, or the capacity of what, 90% of capacity. So you can kind of look and see, yeah, that was okay. If we go back to the plan, I think we can see an individual column. There's a view update button, so we can click that and click on one of these yellow ones, any of these columns. And here's the trial sections over here that are tried. At 1443 worked, the 1240 worked, and at 1039. And these are the weights of each of these columns. And so it selected the lightest series of columns at 1039, weighed a little over about 1100 pounds. 12 by 40 was pretty close. And you can see the interaction equation down here at the bottom is at 0.95. So we're stressed right up there. We're not, I don't like to get too close to 1.0. I like to be under 0.95 or under on my designs personally, because I want a little extra, because Dr. Hazelton, sure enough, is going to come back and put a hot tub in. So well, he's going to move it around. You know? I want a little extra capacity so that when he does that, I can take care of him without having to go back and retrofit a bunch of steel. So I don't like to be more than 0.95 personally. Excuse me, a little extra fluff there. All right, questions?
Questions.
All right, that's all for today that I have. Next time we'll work on the lateral system a little bit.